Hello and welcome back to the gRPC course. In this lecture, we will learn how to implement the server streaming RPC in Java. This RPC will allow us to search for laptops with some filtering conditions. The result will be returned to the client as a stream of laptops. Okay, let's start. I will open the IntelliJ IDEA project that we are working on in previous lectures. As we have already defined the search laptop RPC in the last video, I will just go to the PC Book Golang project and copy two protofiles to our Java project. The first one is a filter message.protofile, and the second one is a laptop service.protofile. Alright, let's review them a bit. This filter message allows us to define some configurations for the laptop that we want to search for. In the laptop service.protofile, we have the search laptop request that contains only the filter, and the search laptop response that contains only the laptop object. We define the server streaming RPC search laptop, which takes the search laptop request as input and returns a stream of search laptop response. Now let's build the project to generate Java code. The build is successful. Let's look at the generated code. As you can see in this laptop service implement base class, there is a new search laptop function that we will have to implement on the server side. Then in the laptop service blocking stub class, there is also a search laptop function that we can use on the client side to call the server. It will return an iterator of search laptop response object. Alright, now we will implement the server side first. Let's start with the laptop store interface. We will define a new search function, which takes the filter as input and sends back the qualified laptops via a laptop stream parameter. This stream is defined as a functional interface with only one method, send, so you can use it as a lambda if you want. I'm going to move this interface to a separate file. Okay, now we have to implement the search function for the in-memory laptop store. In IntelliJ IDEA, just press Option Enter and choose Implement Methods. In this search function, we use a for loop to iterate through all elements of the data map. The value of the entry variable is a laptop. We check if this laptop is qualified to the filter or not. If it is, we just call stream.send to send a deep copy of the laptop to the caller. Okay, let's implement the equalified function. First, if the price of the laptop is greater than the max price of the filter, return false. If the number of calls of the laptop is smaller than the number required by the filter, return false. If the mean frequency of the laptop CPU is less than that of the filter, return false. And finally, if the RAM of the laptop is less than the filter, return false. Here we must write a 2-bit function to convert the memory size to the smallest unit, bit. In this function, we first get the value of the memory. Then we use switch case statement on the memory unit. If it is bit, just return the value. If it is byte, return value shift left 3. This is because 1 byte equals 8 bits, and 8 equals 2 to the power of 3. If the unit is kilobyte, return the value shift left 13, because 1 kilobyte equals 1024, or 2 to the power of 10 bytes, and thus it equals 2 to the power of 13 bits. Similarly, if it is megabyte, return value shift left 23. If it is gigabyte, return value shift left 33. And for terabyte, return value shift left 43. For the default case, just return 0. Okay, now the store is ready. Let's open the laptop service file. We have to override the search laptop function. First, we get the filter from the request. Write a log here saying that we have received a search laptop request with this filter. Then we call store.search function with the filter and provide an implementation of the laptop stream interface. When a laptop is found, we will get it from the send function. So we'll write a log here saying that a laptop with this ID is found. Then we build a response with the laptop. And call responseObserver.onNext function to send this response to the client. In the end, when the search is completed, we call responseObserver.onCompleted to tell the client that there won't be any more responses. Let's write a simple log here as well. Okay, the server is ready. Now let's implement the client. Here I will use a for loop to create 10 random laptops. Then let's create a filter with maximum price of 3000, minimum CPU cores of 4, minimum CPU frequency of 2.5, and minimum RAM of 8 GB. Now we have the filter. We can pass it in the search laptop function. In this function, let's write a log saying the search is started. We create a new search laptop request with the filter. Then we use a blocking stub to call the search laptop RPC on the server. Passing in the created request, it will return an iterator of search laptop response objects. All we have to do is to run through that iterator. And for each response object, we just print out a simple log containing the laptop ID. And finally, we write a log saying the search is completed. And that is for the client. Let's start the gRPC server. Then run the client. It works. Some laptops are found and shown on the client side. And the same on the server side. Okay, now I will show you how to handle timeout or deadline. Suppose that in the search function of the store, each iteration through a laptop in the data map takes 1 second. And on the client side, it sets the request deadline to be after 5 seconds. I will wrap this block inside the tricat and print out the log if an error is caught. All right, let's run the server. Then run the client. After 5 seconds, we got a deadline exceeded error. However, on the server side, it keeps searching for more laptops. I will run the client one more time so that you can see it more clearly. Okay, we've got the error on client side. How about the server? As you can see, it's still searching and several more laptops are filed. But they're useless because the client already cancelled the request. To fix this, we have to check the status of the request context, just like what we did in the unary RPC in the previous lecture. So we must pass the context into the search function of the store. I will add it to this interface first. Then update the in-memory laptop store accordingly. Here in the loop, before doing anything, we will check if the context is already cancelled or not. If it is, we will return immediately. I will write a log here so that we can see it better. Alright, now in the laptop service, we must pass in the current context of the request. Then it's done. Now let's run the server. And the client. When the deadline is exceeded, we can see on the server side, it prints out the log, context is cancelled, and stops searching immediately. Excellent! And that is for today's lecture about server streaming RPC. The unit testing is very similar to unary RPC, so you can try to write it on your own as an exercise. In the next lecture, we will learn how to implement the third type of gRPC, which is client streaming. Until then, happy coding, and I will see you later.